To ensure that names are correctly entered, the best solution is to enter them only once, and if they are misspelled, we'll have only one place to correct. This can be performed by a very convenient feature of the SQL language, which is the ability to perform joins. We have been dealing so far with a single table, but we may have several tables with some common columns, and SQL allows to associate data from one table to data from another table by using the common columns to establish the link. This operation is called a join. Let's see how it works. Suppose that we create a table of directors. In this table, we shall store first name, surname, and perhaps some biographical information. The key will be first name and surname. However, since we want to link movie and directors, and since we want to avoid misspellings, we are going to use a system-generated numerical identifier that will be an alias for the key and that we shall call ID. This will be, technically speaking, a second key, and we can make ID the primary key of the directors table while asking the DBMS to ensure that first name and surname remain unique across the table. Inside the movies table, we shall replace the identification of the director by the ID. Of course, we'll do something similar for actors. When a user wants to retrieve the titles and year of the movies directed by someone whose only surname has been provided, the system will issue an SQL query that will look like this one. We still have a problem with the infrequent movies that have more than one director. Should we reserve two columns for storing director IDs? That would mean joining on two columns, which can be done but isn't most convenient. But two isn't enough. Some movies have three directors. Some even have five. We have the same problem, even more acute, with actors. How many actors should we record? The three leading actors? What about a star-studded movie, such as The Longest Day? What if one day we decide to enrich the database and record more actors, and perhaps the full cast? If we want to add more actor identifiers to the table, we shall have to review all the existing queries to add OR conditions. Storing director and actor identifiers inside the movies table will make the evolution of the application very painful. This isn't, therefore, a good design. And we must try harder. Instead of having one column per director or actor in the movies table, a DBMS allows us to have an intermediate table that, through two joins, will allow us to relate one director to several movies, or several directors to one movie if need be. We shall call this table directed by, and it implements the link between the table of movies and the table of directors. The director and the leading actors will no longer be an attribute of the movie. Since we must reference movies in another table, the real-life key may be a bit difficult to work with. And in the same way as for directors and actors, we are going to ask the system to generate for us a numerical identifier movie ID that will be used as a shorter alias for the title, year and country, and that we'll use to refer to one particular movie. We have the movies, we have the directors, and a new table called Directed By will record the fact that one movie was directed by one director. The primary key of Directed By will be the combination of a movie ID and a director ID. The SQL query to retrieve the information will hardly be more complicated. In the same way, we can also have a table called Played In that links the table that records actors to the movies table. Now, we still have a problem. Orson Welles directed and played in Citizen Kane. And actors turned directors, or directors who occasionally are often playing their own movies, are rather common. If we store separately directors and actors, some information will be duplicated. And if we update one table and forget the other one, we shall have inconsistencies. What we'll really want is to merge the two tables and keep all the information about one person at a single location. Let's ditch once again this model and try last one. We could still keep played in and directed by and make them link the movies table to a people table. Another solution is to merge played in and directed by into a movie credits table that would hold a movie ID, a person ID, and another attribute to tell in which capacity a person participated to the movie, actor or director. This last design is probably better if we plan to also record one day who composed the music, who was the photography director, who designed the set and so on, which would otherwise require one additional table per type of involvement. A good design guarantees data integrity and allows evolution. This is a very simple example, but I hope that it will be enough to convince you of the importance of database design. Thank you for your attention.